think the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, if there's a disease like a ta'un, like a plague, and you are in a city, don't come out of that city. Do not be the cause to spread that disease all over the world. And if you are outside of it, don't go in. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وتركنا على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة أعادنا الله منها يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما اللهم اجعلنا من الفائزين في الدنيا والآخرة. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, our khutbah today is going to be a topic that no one who's here now is unaware of. Whenever you look at the news, whenever you read the papers and the websites, you will always come across, probably the last couple of weeks, the coronavirus. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us in the Quran a number of verses, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ وَنَقْصٍ مِّنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنفُسِ وَالثَّمَرَاتِ وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, مَا أَصَابَ مِن مُصِيبَةٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَلَا فِي أَنفُسِكُمْ إِلَّا فِي كِتَابٍ مِّن قَبْلِ أَن نَبْرَأَهَا إِنَّ ذَلِكَ عَلَى اللَّهِ يَسِيرٌ. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, وَمَا أَصَابَكُم مِّن مُصِيبَةٍ فَبِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِيكُمْ وَيَعْفُ عَن كَثِيرٍ. My brothers and sisters in Islam, there's no doubt that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will test us all. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will test us with many different tests and trials and tribulations. Sometimes illnesses will come. Sometimes wars will be happening. Sometimes afflictions that are other types will be coming. My brothers and sisters in Islam, alhamdulillah, Allah has blessed us with the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And inshallah ta'ala, in our khutbah today, we are going to remind ourselves what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said. If illnesses and ailments and viruses like this come around, and how the companions radiallahu anhum used to deal with it. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what are the ahadith that he has left for us? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said in an authentic hadith, عَجَبًا لِأَمْرِ الْمُؤْمِنِ إِنَّ أَمْرَهُ كُلَّهُ لَهُ خَيْرٌ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, how amazing is the affair of the believer. A believer, his affairs are always good. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if he blesses him with something good, he's thankful and grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But if he's afflicted with calamity and difficulty, that person is also patient. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward him greatly for that. My brothers and sisters in Islam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has told us that a believer should protect himself from things that might harm him. And there are ways that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has reminded us that. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said in this hadith, مَصْطَبَحَ سَبْعَةَ مَرَاتٍ أَيْ عَجْوَةٍ لَمْ يَضُرَّهُ سُمٌّ وَلَا سِحْرٌ ذَلِكَ الْيَوْمِ. Among the hadith that have been narrated from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is this hadith that the believer needs to take precautions, needs to be aware of what is happening, and also to take steps that will be precautionary steps to protect himself from diseases and afflictions that might come his way or her way. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has reminded the Muslims, when you wake up in the morning, if you eat 7 dates, especially the ajwa of Medina, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, that person will not be harmed even by a poison and even sihr, black magic, in that particular day. And Ibn Baz rahimahullah ta'ala has said, if the Muslim cannot even find the tamr of ajwa, the ajwa of Medina, if he uses any other type of date and he uses 7 of them in the morning before he eats anything, that will also be good enough insha'Allah ta'ala. Also, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, man qala fi sabahi kulli yawmin wa masai kulli layla. Anyone who says the morning of every day and the afternoon of every night, bismillah alladhi la yadhurru ma'a ismihi shay'un fi al-ardi wa la fi al-sama' wa huwa al-sami'u al-alim lam yadhurruhu shay'. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, anyone who says every morning and also every afternoon or evening, bismillah alladhi la yadhurru ma'a ismihi shay'un fi al-ardi wa la fi al-sama' wa huwa al-sami'u al-alim, this is going to be a protection for him. Also, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, man qara'a al-ayataini min akhir surah al-baqarah fi laylatin kafatah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, when anyone who recites the last 2 ayahs of surah al-baqarah in the night, they will be sufficient for him from anything. Also, the Prophet, there's a hadith that one of the companions, Abdullah ibn Khubayb, has narrated. He said, خرجنا مع رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم في ليلة مطيرة مظلمة. He said, we went out with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم a night which was very rainy and also very dark. فجعلنا نطلب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال فلقيته فقال لي يا عبد الله قل قلت ما أقول قال قل ثم قلت له ما أقول قال ثم قل قل هو الله أحد والمعوذتين 3 مرات إذا أصبحت وإذا أمسيت تكفيك من كل شيء. Subhanallah. This great companion also has said, we were with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam a night that was absolutely a rainy night and dark, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has left them for a while and then they could not find him, and he said, we went looking out for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he said, I met the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and when I met the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said to me, say ya Abdullah, and I said to him, what do I say ya Rasulullah? He said, say ya Abdullah. I said, what should I say ya Rasulullah? And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, say qul huwa Allahu ahad wal mu'awwidhatayn qul a'udhu bi rabbil falaq and qul a'udhu bi rabbin nas 3 times during the morning and during the evening. What will happen? Takfika min kulli shay, that will give you protection. So we know right now what is happening around us. Cases are always being found that someone is becoming sick with coronavirus, and people are being admitted to hospitals, and people are beginning to become very worried. And even now we know countries and governments are taking precautionary steps. Some of them are even preventing people from going and for allowing people to go to their country. So even that, what we know right now very clearly is, even if someone was planning to go for Umrah, they cannot go for Umrah anymore. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has reminded the companions this particular hadith, and he has also mentioned this amazing hadith where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, إِذَا وَقَعَ وَأَنْتُمْ بِأَرْضٍ أَيْ طَاعُونَ. For example, if there was a plague and a contagious illness, for example, that was killing many people and causing the death and the havoc as well, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if you are in a land and then this illness, and this illness is, for example, is a plague, so what you should be doing is that فَلَا تَخْرُجُوا مِنْهَا. Do not leave that country if you are in that particular country. وَإِذَا وَقَعَ فِي أَرْضٍ فَلَا تَدْخُلُوا إِلَيْهَا. If you are outside of that country and this particular illness is there, don't go into it. The Prophet ﷺ has already told us long time ago. This is something that the Prophet ﷺ has reminded us. And it was said, Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu, there was a time when he was going to Sham, he left Medina, and he was going to Sham, and he was told that a particular city, there was ta'un, there was plague, and he was about to enter that city. And then he was told by some of the companions, do not enter this city. And Umar ibn al-Khattab, he was not sure what to do. So he was thinking, shall I go in? Because why should I fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? He's the one who has written everything. Why should I fear? I should just go in. And then some of the companions were saying to him, don't do it. Don't go in, because if you go in there, you'll fall ill. And then you might die, and you are our Amir al-Mu'mineen. We don't want you to die. And then Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu, this was his methodology. If a matter comes and he doesn't have the right answer, and he would invite the companions, he would gather them together and sit down with them and ask them for their opinions. What do they think? What knowledge do they have about it? And then one of the companions, some of them, they said, yes, Amir al-Mu'mineen, go ahead and enter the city. Don't fear. You should have no fear. If Allah has willed, you will be infected with this disease. Otherwise, nothing is going to happen to you. Just go in. Some of the companions were saying, don't do it. It's very dangerous. If you go in there, you might not come out alive. And then this companion came, it was said it was Abdurrahman ibn Awf, also it was said it was Ubadah ibn Samit radiallahu anhum, one of them. He said, I know something. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, in waqa'a at-ta'un wa antum fi balad fala takhruju minha wa in waqa'a at-ta'un wa antum lastum fiha fala tadkhulu ilayha. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if there's a disease like a ta'un, like a plague, and you are in a city, don't come out of that city. Do not be the cause to spread that disease all over the world. Okay, and if you are outside of it, don't go in. Subhanallah. Who told the Prophet ﷺ this? Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There was no World Health Organization that time. Okay, but the Prophet ﷺ told us, don't do it. MashaAllah, when you look at the Sharia, subhanAllah, you find solution to all the problems. So the Prophet ﷺ, this is what he has given. And still some of the companions were still saying, yeah, they were insisting, yeah, Umar, you should go ahead. And then Umar radiallahu, because some of them have said to him, أَنْتَ تَفِرُّ مِنْ قَدَرِ اللَّهِ. Are you running away from what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has already destined? انظروا ماذا قال عمر إخواني اسمعوا وعوا. Look what Umar رضي الله عنه, very powerful statement. He said, نفر من قدر الله إلى قدر الله. He said, we are running away from the قدر of Allah, but we are running to the قدر of Allah. نفر من قدر الله إلى قدر الله. He said, we are running away from the قدر of Allah because we don't want to go into this city and become sick and die, and at the same time we are running towards the qadr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, where we are going to stay safe, which has Allah has already destined and has written for us as well. So nafirru min qadarillah ila qadarillah. So my brothers and sisters in Islam, inshaAllah ta'ala, in the second part of our khutbah bi'idhnillahi ta'ala, we will also mention what are the steps that we should be taking as Muslims today bi'idhnillahi ta'ala with regards to what is going on around the world. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوهُ إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. الحمد لله على إحسانه والشكر له على توفيقه وامتنانه, وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له, وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, مَا أَصَابَ مِن مُصِيبَةٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَلَا فِي أَنفُسِكُمْ إِلَّا فِي كِتَابٍ مِّن قَبْلِ أَن نَبْرَأَهَا إِنَّ ذَلِكَ عَلَى اللَّهِ يَسِيرٌ. Allah has said, there's no calamity that will afflict you accept no calamity that will afflict you on this earth. في الأرض ولا في أنفسكم, or within yourselves. إلا في كتاب من قبل أن نبرأها. Except it was written in a book way before this time. من قبل أن نبرأها, before you have been created. من قبل أن نبرأها إن ذلك على الله يسير. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, this is easy for me. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, وما أصابكم من مصيبة فبما كسبت أيديكم. Whatever trial and affliction and a problem and a trial that afflicts you, except it is something that your own hands have earned. Humanity in general. ظهر الفساد في البر والبحر بما كسبت أيدي الناس. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, ظهر الفساد. Corruption is everywhere today. Subhanallah. في البر والبحر. On the land and on the ocean. All of them. بما كسبت أيدي الناس. Because of what the people's hands have earned. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has reminded us. As Muslim then, if we are afflicted with this type of this kind of affliction, what should be our stance? As-sabr. As-sabr. Very, very important. Also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said in the Quran, وَإِن يَمْسَسْكَ اللَّهُ بِذُرٍ فَلَا كَاشِفَ لَهُ إِلَّهُ. If Allah afflicts you with harm and hardship and difficulties, no one can lift that away from you except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, وَإِن يُرِدْكَ بِخَيْرٍ. If Allah wants khair and goodness for you, no one can stop that from happening to you. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is very clear. Also the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he reminded the young companion Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma, Ya ghulam ihfadillah yahfadhk. Young man, my dear son, dear ghulam, ihfadillah yahfadhk. Be mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be mindful of you. And then the hadith went on, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, فَعْلَمْ أَنَّ الْأُمَّةَ لَوْ اجْتَمَعَتْ عَلَىٰ أَنْ يَنْفَعُوكَ بِشَيْءٍ. If the ummah, if the people were all together and they all came together to benefit you, لَمْ يَنْفَعُوكَ بِشَيْءٍ إِلَّا بِشَيْءٍ قَدْ كَتَبَهُ اللَّهُ لَكَ. They will not be able to help you with anything except what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has written for you. So what is the Prophet ﷺ teaching this young man, Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma, to put his trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also, فَعْلَمْ أَنَّ الْأُمَّةَ لَوْ اجْتَمَعَتْ عَلَىٰ أَنْ يَضُرُّوكَ بِشَيْءٍ. If all the ummah come together to harm you, they will not be able to harm you except something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has written for you. So my brothers and sisters in Islam, as Muslims, we believe whatever that happens to us is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and nothing will happen to us except what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has written for us. But at the same time, we have to take all the precautionary act and steps which are necessary. My brothers and sisters in Islam, also we need to remind ourselves as mu'min, as Muslims and believers, we need to be one body. المؤمنون كالجسد الواحد إذا اشتكى منه عضو تداعى له سائر. So for example, as believers, we are one body. So if part of us is aching, the rest cannot go to sleep. So we have Muslims and also other human beings, non-Muslims, who are suffering around the world. So whatever help that we can give them is very, very important. So inshallah ta'ala, also I want to clarify a very important point, which is when things like this happen, like for example the coronavirus right now, we know that it started with China. That's where it has originated from. And now it's spreading to all around the world. It's going to Muslim lands, the non-Muslim lands, everywhere. Some of us, we were very quick to attribute to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and say the illness or the virus that have started from China, that is a punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah is punishing China. Okay. Do we have the right to say that? Do we have the knowledge to say that? Are we 100% sure that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has done this because of that? Or there are many other reasons? We have to think before we judge. So brothers, can you make room for your brothers, inshallah? Come forward, jazakumullah, upstairs, downstairs, inshallah ta'ala. So it's very, very important, inshallah ta'ala. We have to know, for example, when things like this happen, we do not kind of like straight away say, this is happening because of this or because of that, because we don't have that knowledge. Okay, as Muslims, we have to be very careful with our words. Very, very important. Because, for example, in China, there are Muslims and non-Muslims that live there. Does that mean Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted also to punish the Muslims who are there? We have to think. This illness doesn't discriminate, doesn't say this person is a Muslim, so I'm not going to affect him. That person is a non-Muslim, I'm going to go and affect him. Think. So it's very, very important that we think. And right now, the disease has gone to the Muslim land. Does that mean Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also is punishing the Muslims? So we have to think, bi'inillahi ta'ala, before we say things like this. Very, very important. But we have to know as Muslims, if these are the principles that we have, if a trial comes to a good person, a believer, that is a test for that person. But if a trial comes and a difficult comes to a non-believer, that could be a punishment for them. Also, it could be a wake-up call for them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, وَلَنُذِيقَنَّهُمْ مِنَ الْعَذَابِ الْأَدْنَى دُونَ الْعَذَابِ الْأَكْبَرِ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ. It's a wake-up call. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala afflicts us with certain difficulties and calamities, it is a wake-up call for human beings. Those who are Muslims and those who are not Muslims. Everybody has to wake up. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, we afflict them with difficulties. Before the bigger punishment, which is the akhirah, ones which are smaller in this world. Okay, why? لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ. So they may return back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, we afflict them, الْبَأْسَاء وَالضَّرَّاء لَعَلَّهُمْ يَضَّرَّعُونَ. It's very, very important. So this is a lesson for all of us, believers, non-believers, Muslims, non-Muslims. Everybody has to learn from this and take the necessary steps. We have to go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, make tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We can see life is very short. Subhanallah, where is the power right now, the superpowers of the world? The virus has arrived and no one is able to do anything about it. This also shows us the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَا يَعْلَمُ جُنُودَ رَبِّكَ إِلَّهُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has many different junood, many different armies. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he can send any type of army to destroy a big nation or powerful people or people who think they're powerful. So we have to remember all of this. So this is a lesson for all of us, inshaAllah ta'ala. Also, my brothers, as precautionary, inshaAllah ta'ala, steps as Muslims, we have to do the following, because alhamdulillah, hygienically, as Muslims, we are very hygienic people. Alhamdulillah, we make wudu 5 times a day minimum, and we wash our hands, alhamdulillah, whatever we are about to eat, when we finish food and so forth. So inshallah ta'ala, this is the advice that is coming from the medical experts. They are always reminding us to be very cautious and also to take the necessary steps to stay clean, inshallah ta'ala, and hygienic as much as possible, bi'idhnillah ta'ala. So for example, if somebody is about to sneeze, if you want to sneeze, for example, is sneeze to the tissue, for example, if you got a tissue. And for example, if anyone has a flu-like symptoms, then to go to their doctors, self-isolate, because you don't know, you could be somebody who's carrying that particular virus. So inshallah ta'ala, you do not want to spread that. So bi'inillahi ta'ala, take all the necessary, inshallah ta'ala, steps which are important to keep you healthy and also the rest of the community, bi'inillahi ta'ala, and society. So these are the steps that we need to take as Muslims, inshallah ta'ala. And also we do not want to kind of like become overly anxious and say, subhanAllah, what's happening? Are we all gonna die? No, inshallah. No one is gonna die unless their time has come. When the time comes, we all die. But no one is gonna die before their time. So inshallah ta'ala, always stay calm, cool, be in the light ta'ala, no panic, no anxiety is needed at all. So inshallah ta'ala, just take the necessary steps, be in the light ta'ala. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا وسلموا تسليما. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم إنا نسألك أن ترفع عنا البلاء ونعوذ بك يا ربنا أن ترفع عنا البلاء والوباء يا حي يا قيوم. اللهم احمنا واحمي جميع إخواننا وأخواتنا في كل العالم. اللهم احمي جميع المسلمين من شر الأمراض والأسقام والأدواء والأورام. اللهم اشف مرضانا، اللهم اشف مرضانا وارحم موتانا يا حي يا قيوم. اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون.